FSG. Members of the FSG from the London industry, members of the teaching faculty, and my own students. It's a sheer pleasure to be back out of the 28th of this pandemic. Some 43 years after I left this campus. It's 1976, I left this campus. I was talking about the principal. Somewhere here, the parents of the school, whatever. I used to sit in the car for a lot of days. Morning when I came, I thought I was very talking about the principal. I talked to the students and students of the law. He said, yes. I was delighted to hear. I belong to a class of 300 students in two sections of this. That's not a difference. We had two sections in our batch. We made it here in 1973 after the graduation. An entire class of 120, over 120, over 120. I think there were over 8 or 9 girls in our class. I see so many girls from the library. I'm really delighted. Reason that the young children are taking interest in the study of law. Actually, as a judge for the last 21 years, at some stage, as I went up the ladder of seniority, I was a member of various committees at the as a judge, as Chief Justice of the Courts, and when the judge of the Supreme Court. One fact which I noticed was, especially in the matter of recruitment of judicial officers, in the three high courts with which I had an association, as well as the Board of Andhra Pradesh, now we were in the room, and the Kerala Board. More often in this competitive examination process, the girls top the list. In 2005, a recruitment in good place for the this we need to scale in the experts get around the page for 10 posts. By then, there was a whole group of people who created a service rules, which provided a 30% of the original information on the service. That size of 10 posts, recruitment process took place. Five girls were successful. Top two, they came on very normal reservation. Top two girls. Apart from that, virtual reservation and other things. This is a phenomenon I've been noticing, at least in these years, Kerala and Northeast, Northeast. The girls couldn't give a very fierce competition to the course. And I'm not surprised in a few years to come, this study of law and the legal profession perhaps will be dominated by the girls. And I think the classroom today reinforces my belief in all of us. At the outset, I'd like to make several things clear. The principal was mentioning that, of course, my love for this institution is endowment. But insofar as the endowment lecture, endowment created, there will be a school of graduate lecture tomorrow. not having been treated. Some of my relatives, I didn't want to go as a year away from that. Some of my personal friends were very difficult. So, no, it's all right. It's all right. And I'm sad for one thing. Sad for myself and sad for the system, the institution. I never saw Prof. Ambedkar, but it was even by the time I entered the operator in 1976, Prof. Ambedkar had retired because the V.S. Murthy was the head of the party. But Prof. Venkataraman's name was really addressed to V.S. It was almost a day-to-day mention in the podcast of the conference last morning. After the meeting, Paul came in and got them. A lot of people together. Somebody else always mentioned. Sad for myself, notwithstanding the kind of popularity was awarded from India. I really never had to study the profile of the man. Eventually, when I was called upon to deliver this lecture, I started answering. Nowadays, only people like them who bring skills. I'm sure I don't have them, they're more proficient than me in these matters. With the advent of the internet, almost everything is available on the net. Most of it. Went to the internet. But to my utter sadness, not much of it is available on the system. I'm more sad for the institution. That is part of the Indian culture. We are a race with no great respect for history. We believe more in favor of that's part of the Indian tradition and culture for more good bad reasons. There are philosophical underpinnings for this. All of us sitting in this hall, those speaking to people. I presume the majority of the people speaking to you are those speaking. Are certainly familiar with the name Krishnadevaraya, the medieval ruler of South India, with the victor of contention over the Telugu or Kannada. Which caste you are, that's not going to work. He was a man who ruled two-thirds of the present South India, that is, within five states, Andhra, Telangana, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, this part of Kerala. Two-thirds of the territory he ruled. From the material available on the record to us, he ascended the throne in 1509 and died sometime in 1529-30, even that is not for sure. His exact date of birth is not known. His exact date of death is not known. His ancestry beyond three generations is not known. On the other hand, Henry VIII, who was a contemporary of Krishnadevaraya, period of all life, you have the armory which he wore available for looking at in the Tower of London, and whose life history is given in great detail available. We have a lot of reference to the new resin. I don't know what is the interest which the present generation evinces in literature. తెలుగులో సృష్టిగా పద్యం అవుతుంది. అది చెప్తే నువ్వు ఇంద్రుడవని చంద్రుడవని ఇంద్రశుద్ధవని చంద్రహితుడవని చంద్రహితుని శుద్ధవని చంద్రహితుని చంద్రశుద్ధుని ఇంద్రుడవని హరి హరి
of the able minds in the world.
and I think explained that we do not go to the prepared their background, their abilities, their work, and stop this as far as reflection is concerned. Now the topic for today, I chose the rule of law and the Indian Constitution. Your Western Constitution, obviously, has a lot of science and whatever. When I'm dealing with the law, totally honestly, I became curious about the topic. I was searching, what is this mythical beast for rule of law? It is a concept. All of the students of law by now, unless the first year or something that he was not introduced to this concept, must be aware of this phrase, rule of law. I mean, some of you will progress to the higher classes, second, third years, who will study the Constitution of law. As you might be having a slightly better view of the time. So let us understand what exactly is this rule. You don't think that I'm being a little pedantic about it. There were phases in human history earlier. Law was what the rulers set in monarchies. Even now in some countries where absolute dictators exist, law has its own connotations there. This way, the king, with the march of human history and with the innate urge of human beings to be free, the human society started asserting that there must be some rationality in this lawmaking process, and it can't be left to the whims and caprice of individuals. And the old theory of the rule by divine right is no more good for the king. Slowly, this realization on the part of the human beings that people are born free and they're entitled to rule their matured into ideas of liberty by laws meant not by individuals but by plurality of people. You go back to history, the ancient city-states of Greece to take all the decisions regarding law. Including application of law. I'm sure, your friends, all of you have heard the name of Socrates. The man was adjudged to be a enemy of the state. He was condemned to death. The penalty was implemented by administering poison to Socrates, poisonous for hemlock. He was killed, one of the greatest killers known to mankind. But remember, it was not a decision of an individual judge who declared Socrates to be an enemy of the people. It is the whole citizenry of the city of Athens which gathered and declared him to be an enemy of the state. If democracies are only about numbers, the punishment and the execution of Socrates was a great act of democratic wisdom. Because the entire system is that way. There's not an individual in Chelameswar expert who decided that Socrates was fired by the government. The entire system. But then it is certainly democracy because all the people participate. But the question is whether it's liberal democracy. Liberal democracy is have certain other attributes. It's not only that you take a decision, the majority, but the decision should also conform to certain basic norms of justice. What are those basic norms that are not to be talking about? Then these theories of liberal democracy came into existence.